Canelo versus Triple G.
For the win! He did it!
You're watching or listening to the For the Win podcast.
Yeah, it's kind of a good one.
It's a good one. I guess we'll do like a different sport a week.
Yeah. And here's the super interesting thing about this podcast is usually it'll be me and you, or you and me. I literally don't know anything about most sports.
See, I'm more traditional. I was thinking about this earlier. I'm a traditional sports fan. You are non-traditional. So this works perfectly. Much better than basketball.
Yeah.
You know, I know the three traditional, you know, like UFC and boxing and billiards.
You know
the weird shit.
Yeah. For the most part, really my bag is MMA.
Yeah.
I love it. I personally am not a very violent person.
Yeah, okay.
I don't know.
Let's jump into this. Okay, so I don't know anything about boxing. I listened to the Dan Le Batard show this morning to prepare for this. So what I've learned is Triple G is maybe a few years past his prime.
He's getting up there. He is, yeah.
Okay. He's all power. He's got one of the most powerful jabs in the boxing world. Canelo is very calm, composed, very Floyd Mayweather-like to his approach.
Well,
he's maybe smarter than Triple G. He's got the more fundamentally sound than Triple G is what I heard.
So let's just give a little bit of background.
Okay.
I really, really like MMA. Before Conor and Floyd was announced, I started to watch a little bit of Triple G. I didn't watch any Canelo then. And then really what I was doing was I was going back and watching Mike Tyson, Muhammad Ali.
Oh, right.
You know, things like that, just because I wanted to just see how I felt about it. Because one time it was like someone said, I think it was like the Joe Rogan podcast or something like that. And they were just like, Triple G has knockout power.
Yeah.
Now, me personally, I understand what a knockout is, and I know how bad it is for you, but I like watching them.
Yeah.
I know, like, those people are going to be jacked up after they get knocked out. You know, especially from, like, have you watched Triple G knock people out?
Yeah, we've watched some together.
Golly, those are bad knockouts.
It's powerful. Yeah,
those
really
are
is.
Bad knockouts. And, like, It's so interesting. So I watched a lot of stuff for this fight. I'm not going to get to watch it live, but I've watched a lot of things for this fight. So Max Kellerman, he's like a big boxing analyst guy. And he does a show called Under the Lights where they get together, and it was like Triple G, Canelo, and then it was another boxer and I can't remember his name, but he's like an old school legend. But anyway, so they were talking to each other, and it's so weird that this is being promoted for like this is the fight that boxing fans deserve. You know, like the little bit that I know about boxing, people are like, this is the fight. This is the fight. And so coming from like an MMA background, I'm looking at Conor. I'm looking at not really George St. Pierre, But Luke Rockhold. I'm looking at all these up and comers. Even there's some up and comer people. So like Luke Rockhold, Michael Bisping, all these MMA fighters, and they are trash talkers. They're super trash talkers. And then so it's like that hypes a fight. My wife and a friend of ours, whenever. I'll watch it. I don't care who's around. Like, if the TV's free, I can watch, like, UFC. I'll watch the trash talk. I'll watch the fights and everything. Like, a lot of people, like, my wife does not understand, like, the purpose of trash talk. She hates it.
Yeah.
I love it.
Whenever,
and forgive me, I'm off the John Jones wagon. I'm not a fan of his anymore. But when he said, I beat you after a weekend of cocaine, I love that.
That's some good shit.
Yeah,
that's good.
I loved it. And then so coming from that and then going up into like this fight, because then it's like Connor and Floyd, lots of trash talk.
Right.
Lots of trash talk. And then people call it a spectacle, you know, like boxing heads called it a spectacle and everything. And then we watched it. I loved it.
Yeah.
You know, I thought it was really good. But then they're like, this is the fight we deserve. Now, have you watched any of their interviews or anything? Mm-hmm. Dude, like, I respect how respectful they are of each other, but there's, like, no, like, it's like Canelo, all he does, he can't speak English at all. Straight
oh, really?
Spanish. Yeah, he looks, he's a ginger.
Yeah.
Looks white, but no English. All Spanish. In fact, I found out from people who speak Spanish, mm-hmm. They tell me Canelo is actually a play on the word cinnamon. Like, that's his name.
Oh, shit.
Like, his name is Cinnamon because he has red hair, you know? And so, but he's straight, you know, speaking Spanish, no English.
Right.
There's no enthusiasm in his voice. There's no, like, I'm going to stop this guy. This is not, I'm going to embarrass this guy. There's none of that. It's just like.
This is like a cold-blooded killer.
Yeah, this is a cold-blooded killer, and he's just like, this is the most dangerous fight in my career.
Holy
That's
shit.
All he says. He said, this is the most dangerous fight in my career, but I'm going to win. You know,
Damn.
Just like, that's it. And then Triple G, same thing. He's just like, I just want to put on a good show. You know, like, he's just like, I want to put on a good show. And he's like, he's very, very fat, you know, like, very dangerous, very toughest fight in my career. You know, same thing. They're both saying that. There's no, like, I'm going to stop
that's
this
so
mother.
Weird.
Like, this guy is trash, you know? Because there could be, because from what I understand, for a long time, fans have said, oh, Canelo's ducking Triple G.
Yeah.
Canelo doesn't want to fight Triple G.
No, that was one thing I heard on the Dan Le Batard show as well, is this is super similar to the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight.
Mm-hmm.
Like, people have been asking for it for 5 or 6 years, and it's just now finally happening when they're a little bit past their prime.
Yeah, but that's the thing. Canelo's definitely not past his prime. In fact, Triple G, people say, like, he's, you know, his last fight he was looking a little sloppy. I don't think so. Like, from what I saw, yeah, he wasn't as like, much of a superstar, but he won the fight. And so, when we're looking at records here, we're looking at Triple G, who has never lost.
Okay.
Versus Canelo, who's lost one time in his life, and that was to Floyd Mayweather when he was young.
Right, okay, I remember that.
That was when Canelo was young boxer, he lost to Floyd Mayweather.
Okay.
And then that's it. And so, when you look at it, like, there's, I just like, professional boxers or retired boxers, they just say, like on that Under the Lights, the very end, Max Kellerman was like, Canelo, how's this end? He says, I don't know. It's a tough fight. We're just going to have to see what
That's
happens.
That's nuts.
And then Triple G, how's this end? I don't know. We just
That's
have
crazy.
To see. And then they asked the retired fighter, to say, how's it going to end? He said, does it go the distance? Basically, I forget. He said, does it go the distance? I don't know. Does it go the distance? I don't know. Does it go this? He didn't know. Way. Someone's putting someone to sleep. Someone's putting someone to sleep.
So,
I don't know who it is.
So what sense then does it make for Triple G, who's like, you know, like a few years past, like prime Triple G, what sense does it make to take on Canelo now instead of a few years ago?
So basically what happens is it's the promotions. So from what I understand, you don't get to say, hey, I want to fight that person. I'm going to fight that person. You have these people that are like your team, and they try and help you promote your career. Because not only they succeed by you succeeding. So if they don't want you to fight Triple G, they're gonna push you towards other people. You know what I mean? And so that's what I think has happened.
Oh, I see.
And they say, hey, Canelo's ducking Triple G. He don't want to fight him. No, I don't believe that. I don't believe that at all. I think that Canelo will fight anybody. And I think Triple G will fight anybody. And so, from what I understand, these are the two best fighters in that weight class. But another thing that I understand that makes this fight super interesting is Triple G is an aggressor. He's coming at you. And then Canelo is a counter-striker. So, the way that their fighting styles match perfectly.
Okay.
And so someone made a really interesting point, and they said, like, they were talking about predictions for this fight, and they said, literally any way that this fight ends is something you could have predicted. If Canelo knocks out Triple G, could have predicted it. If Triple G knocks out Canelo, could have predicted it. If it goes the distance, could have predicted it. Like, this, they are so perfect for each other. Like, they're such perfect dance partners for each other.
Really?
That,
really?
Yeah. That it's just, it's anyone's game at this point.
So this fight feels like in the situation where waiting so long, you say the promoters have a big say in it.
I feel like it, yeah.
So this is like, the reason it's taken so long is people ask for it one time. Like, you don't want to give it to them immediately. You want the hype to build.
Oh, yeah.
Right? So this is probably like the 10th time people are asking for it, and they're finally coming together. Even though they're a little, Triple D's a little older, like, it still sounds like everyone's confident this is going to be, like,
the best fight in years. Yeah. They're like, this is what boxing fans deserve, is what they say.
Damn.
Yeah, I know it, right? And the thing is, like, that's why it's so strange that everyone hated on Conor versus Floyd, because that put a lot of eyes on that sport.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Right in time for the fight that the fans deserve, from what I understand. So it's like, get everyone watching, and while everyone's watching, hit them with a hard show. Just like that. Boom.
All right, that's it. I have three questions, and we can wrap this.
All right.
All right, question one. Which fight has a bigger impact on the future of boxing than Canelo Triple G or Mayweather-McGregor?
Mayweather-McGregor.
I think so.
And I don't care. I don't care. I know.
Now, I'm not talking UFC or MMA. I'm talking just strictly boxing.
Yeah, straight boxing. I think because if you think about pay-per-view records and eyeballs watching, it got the most eyes watching because of Conor. Because
that's
of
true.
Those UFC fans.
Yeah.
Those UFC fans, maybe it's their first time into the sport. And, like, the people that we were watching with, you know, I had to tell one friend, they were like, man, are they going to be laying on each other? And I said, no, it's straight, just punching.
Yeah, exactly.
Punching to the body, punching to the head. And they're like, I'm in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, like, all these new eyes for, like, people who are just like, you know, you don't know what, you know, really what it is. I know for me, I looked at it and I watched a few things, especially for Triple G. Lomachenko, definitely.
Right, right, yeah.
And then old stuff. But then it was like, I'll watch that. And then it's like, okay, here's the next one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's watch that. You know, let's learn about that. And they got some good stuff. I really like it. So, I think it was super helpful for that sport. And then this one has a just as an important role, because it's like, okay, you got my attention. Now what are you going to do with it?
Yeah, exactly.
So,
exactly. That sounds like it's planned. All right, question two.
Mm-hmm.
If, let's say, Triple G is Rocky,
mm-hmm.
who is Canelo in the Rocky universe?
Mm-hmm.
Is he Clover Lang? Is he...
Is that Russian dude?
He's a Russian.
Yeah.
I can't think of another damn boxer. Apollo Creed, Clover Lang? That's the only
one. Nah.
Who would you call?
I'd say he's...
Canelo.
I'd say... Well, actually... No, because Apollo Creed was like showboaty, like Ali. And then the Russian was just like, I'm going to kill you. So he's not really either of those guys, because he respects Triple G.
That's weird. Okay, yeah.
So he respects Triple G, and the fact that he understands this is a very dangerous fight for him.
Okay.
And here's the thing. Both of them are very, very aware that the whole fight, not only that night, but their whole lives. Because let's talk about brain damage. Let's talk about,
they could,
you
really
know, career. Their whole lives can be changed from one hit. If you're thinking knockout power from Triple G.
Yeah, exactly.
It can rock your world. One hit, the whole one night can change your whole life.
Shoot.
You know?
That's
and
terrifying.
So they definitely are aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know who I would call him.
No.
I don't know.
Weird. All right, so in my limited view of boxing,
mm-hmm.
like in Mayweather, McGregor, I took McGregor because he's the better striker.
Yeah.
So this fight, I'm going the opposite. I'm going Canelo because, I don't know, I feel like I went with the heavy-handed person
mm-hmm.
in the last fight, so I'm going to go with Canelo this mm-hmm. fight. Who are you taking? One word, three, two, one.
Ugh. Well, can I say
this? Just say the name. Just say the name.
I'll go Canelo.
You going Canelo?
Mm.
Okay.
I'll go Canelo. Man, I want to say why, though. Because I feel like... I'm just going to do it anyway. Let's hear it. Because you can cut it if you want. Oh,
okay, we'll hear.
So, basically, if it goes the distance in the judges pick, it's something called... Who's throwing it is called Golden Boy Productions, I think. Our promotions. Golden Boy Promotions. That's Canelo's promotion. So, if you think... hash Triple G fought in big fights. Yes. Never in this kind of arena, though. So, who's going to make these people the most money? It would be Canelo. It's his promotion. He's the main star for that.
Okay.
For that thing. And so, if it goes the distance and judges pick, Canelo all day. He's got it every day of the week.
So, you're saying you think it'll go the distance?
If it does, yeah, it will. But he does. He has a legitimate chance for stopping him.
Okay.
He's a great counter puncher. He really is. That's the thing. Like, Triple G also just rock him.
Just a few, 3 or 4 punch combo. We could fucking put him on the mat.
Yeah. And I already know who Kai's going to pick.
I don't.
You don't?
No. I'm so excited to hear his analysis on this.
Man, I'm saying he's picking Triple G all day.
I feel like... He would.
I do. I think, you know, he might be a Triple G nut hugger, you know?
I don't know. That being said, well, thank you for watching and listening to the For the Win podcast. First one. We tried to do a podcast with Kai, but he lives in Heidenheim, Germany.
Yep.
And there's a big old time difference. So we couldn't really make it work out. Somebody would be up at like 3 or 4 a.m. either way. So we got him to record a video of his analysis of the fight and his prediction. We'll put that in right about here.
Okay, so before I get going with my prediction of what I think the fight's going to look like, I'd just like to say that I'm a huge Gennady Golovkin fan. Been watching him for 5-6 years now. That was when he was still... not as well known in the U.S. because he wasn't on HBO yet. He wasn't really fighting in America much. And he was really popular in Germany, though, because he was fighting at a lot of undercards, actually, in the beginning. And then having a lot of fights internationally. So he was a lot more known internationally than he was in the U.S., I think. Because the U.S., you know, has this huge Latino market. So guys like Miguel Cotto, Canelo Alvarez... Chavez and people like that, obviously Floyd and Pacquiao, were a lot more popular than Gennady was. So when all the German boxers kind of started to decline a little bit, I actually picked up on Golovkin and started following him, which is why, despite the fact that I love Canelo, I enjoy watching Canelo a lot, I would consider myself a Golovkin fan and would hope that Golovkin is gonna take the win in this fight. So now getting to my prediction, I actually just see this fight going to, well, let's say three ways. Golovkin's gonna win on points, Golovkin's gonna win by knockout, or Canelo is gonna win by knockout. The reason I say that is because I just simply don't see a way where Canelo is gonna be the aggressor and dominate in the ring. And land more punches than Golovkin is, simply because when you look at Canelo has a tendency to be a careful fighter. So he's gonna pick his shots. He's not gonna go in wild and just get himself out of position. Really, he's really careful with how he moves. He's gonna create angles, and then when he sees that there's an opportunity, then he's gonna try to take advantage of that. That only really changes, and you kind of saw that against Amir Khan, even though he brutally knocked him out. You saw that Canelo was starting to get a little worried because Khan was starting to be more and more aggressive, stepping in and hitting Canelo, hurting Canelo. And what that did was Canelo would kind of reach, wind up, throw wild shots. And that's when he really put himself out of position, and that's when he became vulnerable, because that's not who he is. He's more of a careful guy. He's going to pick his shots, and then when he sees that you're opening up, or he sees that he can march in because you're starting to get defensive, that's when he's starting to throw combinations. And when he's starting to throw combinations, he has some of the fastest hands, definitely in the middleweight division, but I would say in all of boxing, just because he's so smooth and fluid when he throws combinations, how he does his damage usually. As for Golovkin, Golovkin kind of reminds me of a young Mike Tyson, only with less power, obviously, and a lot less weight on his body. The reason I say that is because Golovkin kind of resembles the mentality that Tyson had when he was fighting under Kevin Rooney and Custamato, because he kind of resembles that I'm going to swallow a punch in order to deliver one attitude. So what that means is Golovkin is going to step in. He's going to, usually, and I expect this fight to be the same, he's going to be the aggressor. He's going to have the middle of the ring, and he's going to chase Canelo around. And what he usually does is he steps in, delivers punches, and he opens up a lot. And people touch him. People don't really hurt him, or I haven't seen Golovkin hurt, really, up to this point. I think Daniel Jacobs was the closest Golovkin has ever gotten to being hurt, but that was not necessarily hurt. I think that was more being stunned and held back a little and slowed down in his actions, just because Daniel Jacobs did a hell of a job of moving around and slipping and trying to create angles and getting out of the lane. And I think that's what Canelo needs to do. I think he needs to get out of the lane. He needs to create angles and not let Golovkin march straight in, because when Golovkin marches straight in, I think Canelo is going to... I don't think Canelo is going to be able to take the punches that Golovkin is going to deliver, no matter how much he's going to touch Golovkin. Simply because I think Canelo can land three punches. If Golovkin lands one to the temple or connects to the jaw one time, I think Canelo is not going to be able to take it. Which is why, if you ask me, I would say this fight... and I changed my mind on that recently, just recently, because I was convinced that Canelo was going to win the fight. But I believe, after watching a lot of highlights, watching a lot of tapes, watching them train, and especially focusing on the way that they handle themselves in certain situations, as for how Canelo reacts to being pressured, being walked down, and how Golovkin reacts to someone trying to slip, trying to create angles, I think that Golovkin is going to win the fight. I think he's going to win the fight by knockout. I don't think he's going to drop Canelo. I think the fight's going to be stopped. I think it's going to be a TKO. Meaning the ref's going to step in, for those of you guys that are not too familiar with boxing. The reason for that is that I think Canelo is going to start to tire, simply because he has grown into his body and he's gotten more and more used to the weight that he's carrying in the middleweight division, but still it's not necessarily his natural weight. I think he's more of a lighter fighter compared to Golovkin, who usually carries a heavy body around and is used to it. So I think Canelo is not going to be able to create the angles necessary to be created when you're trying to avoid Gennady Golovkin. So I think starting around, let's say round 7 or 8, and up to that point I think is going to be a competitive fight. Canelo might even lead in points up to that point. But I think starting round 6, 7, definitely round 8, that's when Canelo is going to start to slow down a little bit, get a little tired, and that's when Golovkin is going to step in, and that's when he's going to hurt him. And really all Golovkin needs, and that's kind of where he's similar to Tyson again, he needs that one punch. And if he catches you one time, I don't think Canelo is going to be able to box with him anymore. My opinion, I would say fight's going to end around, if I had to give you a round, I would say round 10. Round 10 is where I think Golovkin is going to stop Canelo. I think it's going to be a hell of a fight though. I think it's going to be really, really competitive. I think Canelo is going to be a lot more aggressive than people might assume. I think he's going to try to hurt Golovkin. I just honestly don't think he's going to be able to do it. Simply because in order to hurt Golovkin, you need to hurt him with combinations. You need to hit him a couple times, touch him a couple times. And Golovkin's just too powerful for someone else to swallow a Golovkin punch in order to throw a combination. And that's where I think Canelo is going to be brought to his limits. Simply because he's not going to be able to take... one of Golovkin's uppercuts when they're in the clinch, or Golovkin's powerful jab, which is one of the more powerful jabs, kind of similar to what Vladimir Klitschko was throwing a lot. Just not a jab to create distance, but a jab to hurt people. And I just don't think Canelo is going to be able to take that. So I would say Golovkin's going to win the fight, TKO, after round 10, which would be the first loss for Canelo since the Floyd fight, which came way too early. So that's kind of a bit of a shame that we never got to see either Golovkin or Canelo fight Floyd in his prime. Floyd obviously being a little older, but Golovkin or Canelo in their prime, as Canelo was just way too young at that point and the fight came way too early. This is a fight of two fighters who are still pretty much in their prime. I think Golovkin's starting to age a little bit maybe, but still pretty much in his prime. Canelo finally growing into the middleweight division and being more comfortable with his weight and then just becoming more and more technically sound. The gap has closed. I think Golovkin used to be just marching over everybody in the middleweight division. And a couple years back, I think it would have been pretty much the same. I think it's not that he's going to march over Canelo anymore. I just think eventually in the later rounds, round 7, 8, 9, and then definitely 10 when I think he's going to stop the fight. It's just going to become too much for Canelo to handle the power as it has been for pretty much anybody except for Daniel Jacobs, which is why I think the winner of this fight, which I think is going to be Golovkin, but even if it's Canelo, I think the next fight has to be against Daniel Jacobs, giving him another chance at a belt, simply because he stood in the ring for 12 rounds with Golovkin and gave him a good run for his money and pretty much being or taking away as little damage as I've ever seen anyone take away from a fight against Gennady Golovkin. So that's pretty much it for me. I'm excited for the fight. I'm definitely going to be watching it, even though it's going to be at 5 in the morning in Germany. Hope you guys all enjoy it. And yeah, let's hope for a good fight.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching.
Next time, football! Yeah!